five factors which are affecting on the base 10. The first factor is availability of lone pair electrons, electron pairs. The second factor is electronegativity of atom B. The third factor which is affecting on base 10, the structural effect in B. B is a general base. The fourth factor is the stability of conjugate acid. And the last factor we have discussed, the nature of solvent. These are the five factors which is useful to decide the base 10 for different types of organic compound. Now, in today's lecture, we discuss the relative base strength for aliphatic amines. The relative base strength for the aliphatic amines. What is the relative base strength for the aliphatic amine? Consider the primary amine. Consider we go from ammonia to primary amine. As we go from all organic amines, centrally amines are basic compound because in amines nitrogen atom have lone pair electron, and in presence of lone pair electron it can donate this pair of electron to H plus ion. And all amines, all organic amines, aliphatic amines, aromatic amine and heterocyclic amines generally act as a base. These are the Lewis bases. What is the definition of base? According to Lewis concept, base is the substance which can donate the electron pair. Generally, this is known as the base. The five factors we have discussed, these five factors are generally useful to decide the relative base strength for aliphatic amines, aromatic amines and the heterocyclic amine. With the help of five factors, we discuss the five factors. The availability of electron pair, electronegativity of atom B, then structural effect, stability of conjugate acid and nature of solvent. With the help of these five factors, we can decide the relative base strength for the different organic compound. Now, in today's lecture, we discuss the relative base strength for the aliphatic amines. As we go from ammonia to primary amine to secondary amine, as we go from primary to secondary amine and secondary to tertiary amine, in tertiary amine, nitrogen atom attached to three different alkyl groups. There is no hydrogen atom on nitrogen. In secondary amine, nitrogen is attached to two different alkyl groups. In primary amine, nitrogen have only one alkyl group. As we go from ammonia to primary amine, one of the hydrogen atom in ammonia replaced by alkyl group. This is the primary amine. Two hydrogen in ammonia replaced by two alkyl group. The two, both alkyl groups are same or different. The secondary amine, and this is the tertiary amine. It is a primary, it is a secondary, and it is a tertiary amine. As we go from primary to ammonia to primary amine, primary to secondary and secondary to tertiary amine, the number of alkyl group goes on increasing. There is no alkyl group in ammonia, but in primary amine there is one alkyl group. In secondary amine there is a two alkyl group. In tertiary amine there is a three alkyl group. As the number of alkyl group increases, electron donating inductive effect increases, the plus I effect increases, and as a plus I effect increases, the electron density around the nitrogen atom. This nitrogen atom have the electron pair, lone pair electron. As the number of alkyl group increases, alkyl group have electron donating inductive effect, the plus I effect. As the number of alkyl group increases, plus I effect increases, and as a plus I effect increases, electron density around the nitrogen atom increases and lone pair electron easily available for donation, then donation of electron pair are easily occurs. On the basis of electronic effect, inductive effect, what is the expected order of base 10? The ammonia is weaker base than primary amine. Primary amine is weaker than than secondary amide, and secondary amide is weaker than the tertiary amide. It is expected order of basicity for this base, expected order of base strength for this compound, as the number of alkyl group increases as we go from ammonia to primary amide to secondary, and secondary to tertiary amide. The number of alkyl group increases as the number of alkyl group increases, plus I effect increases. And what is the role of plus I effect? Plus I effect increases electron density around the nitrogen atom, as electron density around the nitrogen atom increases, availability of electron pair increases. As availability of electron pair increases, the base strength increases. On the basis of inductive effect, on the basis of electronic effect, what is the expected order of base strength? The expected order of base strength is primary ammonia is weaker than primary amide. Primary amide is weaker than secondary amide, and secondary amide is weaker than the tertiary amide. But what is the pKa value? The base strength are generally measured in terms of pKb value. Ammonia has pKb value 4.75. Primary amide have pKb value 3.36. Secondary amide have pKb value 3.40. And tertiary amide have pKb value 4.20. The pKb value indicate ammonia is, as a smaller the pKb value, stronger will be base. If pKb value is a small, the given compound should be strong base. Then consider the relative base strength for aliphatic amines. These are the aliphatic amines. Primary, secondary, tertiary amines are aliphatic amines. In aliphatic amine, nitrogen atom have aliphatic groups. Alkyl groups attached to nitrogens are aliphatic. They are saturated sp3 hybridized carbons. Alkyl groups are generally attached to nitrogen. What is the relative base strength? We discussed the structural effect. According to the structural effect, plus I effect means electron donating inductive effect, and plus R effect means electron donating resonance effect. These two effect increases the base strength, because in both effect electron density around the nitrogen atom due to the electron donation increases, and as electron density increases, availability of electron pair increases, and as availability of electron pair increases, base strength is increases. In these amines, we go from ammonia to primary, primary to secondary, and secondary to tertiary amine. Number of alkyl group increases. As the number of alkyl group increases, plus I effect increases, and as the plus I effect increases, electron density around the nitrogen atom goes on increasing, and due to this reason, availability of electron pair increases. Due to the electron donation, number of alkyl group increases, plus I effect increases, electron density around the nitrogen atom increases, and availability of electron pair goes on increasing, and base strength is increases. It is the expected order of base strength on the basis of inductive effect. But pKb value generally indicate tertiary amine have high pKb value than secondary and primary amine. This tertiary amine is weaker than the secondary amine and primary amine. What is the reason? In this case, the structural effect, that is the inductive effect, is not useful to decide the base strength. Expected order of, as we go from primary to secondary, consider the primary amine is methyl amine, we have pKb value 3.36. Secondary amine is dimethyl amine, it has pKb value 3.20. And tertiary amine, trimethyl amine, it has pKb value 4.20. Number of methyl group increases, plus I effect increases, availability of electron pair increases, because electron density around the nitrogen atom is increases. But expected order of base strength is not according to the electronic effect, inductive effect. In case of tertiary amine, plus I effect is high, but it is weaker than the secondary amine on the basis of pKb value. It have large pKb value 4.20, it have 3.20. PKB value indicates secondary amine is stronger than the tertiary amine. Electronic effect, inductive effect is high in tertiary amine, but it is weaker than secondary amine because of we generally measure the base strength in aqueous solution, generally in water. In aqueous solution, the base strength of aliphatic amine is depends on the solvation. It is depends on nature of solvent. It does not, in this case, inductive effect is not important to decide the base strength. Inductive effect is not important. In this case, the solvent, the solvation effect is important. Consider the secondary amine. If the secondary amine, then consider this is the secondary amine, dimethyl amine. When it accepts the H plus ion in water solution, consider we can measure the base strength in water solution. This conjugate acid is formed. In according to inductive effect, expected order of base strength is primary is weaker than secondary, secondary is weaker than tertiary. On the basis of inductive effect, expected order of base strength for primary, secondary and tertiary amine is primary is weaker than secondary, secondary is weaker than tertiary. But PKB value indicate tertiary amine is weaker than primary and secondary amine. What is the reason why tertiary amine is weaker base than the secondary and primary amine? The reason for this case are we measure the base strength in solvent, generally in water solvent, in aqueous medium. In an aqueous medium, electronic effect, inductive effect is not important to decide the base strength. In this case, stability of conjugate bases, conjugate acid is important. In aqueous medium, base strength, to decide the base strength, electronic effect is not important. The important role to decide the base strength are stability of conjugate acid. If the conjugate acid of secondary amine is formed, it is solvated by two water molecules. Consider in aqueous medium, this hydrogen make the hydrogen bonding with water, and second hydrogen also make the hydrogen bonding with water. Its solvation is a high. In this case, consider conjugate base or conjugate acid, sorry, for the tertiary amine. Tertiary amine accept the electron pair. If the tertiary amine accept the electron H plus ion, it can donate the electron pair and accept the H plus ion. It have only one hydrogen or nitrogen. In secondary amine conjugate acid have two hydrogen. There is a two water molecule solvate this conjugate acid, and conjugate acid of tertiary amine solvated by only one water molecule. As a number of, as the solvation increases, stability of conjugate acid increases, and as the stability of conjugate acid increases, the base strength is increases. This is the reason the conjugate acid of secondary amine, similar to this primary amine conjugate acid, is solvated by four water molecules. There is three water molecules. This solvation is high in primary and secondary amine than tertiary amine. The conjugate acid of primary and secondary amine are more stable than conjugate acid of the tertiary amine, and due to this reason, in aqueous medium, the relative base strength, the tertiary amine is weaker than primary and secondary amine. In aqueous medium, the tertiary amine is weaker than the primary and secondary amine, because in aqueous medium, conjugate acid of tertiary amine is less stable. It is solvated by only one water molecule, but secondary amine conjugate acid is solvated by, the solvation is high. As the solvation is high, stability of conjugate acid is high. This is the acid strength, relative, this is the relative base strength, sorry. This is the relative base strength for the amine in aqueous medium. If we measure the base strength in non-polar solvent like ether, chlorobenzene, then relative base strength for the amine are considered. Primary amine is weaker than secondary, and secondary amine is weaker than, the secondary amine is weaker than the tertiary amine. This is the relative base strength in non-polar solvent. If we measure the base strength for primary, secondary and tertiary amine in non-polar solvent, solvation does not occur. In non-polar solvent, electronic effect, inductive effect decide the base strength. As the number of alkyl group increases, inductive effect increases, electron density around the nitrogen atom increases, and base strength increases from primary to secondary and secondary to tertiary amine. But in polar solvent like water, the base strength are primary is weaker than secondary. Primary is weaker than secondary, but secondary is stronger than the tertiary amine. The secondary amine is a stronger base than the tertiary amine. In aqueous medium, in polar solvent, the solvation effect is important. The conjugate acid stability is important. The conjugate acid of secondary amine is more solvated than conjugate acid of tertiary amine, and due to this reason, secondary amine is stronger than the tertiary amine in aqueous medium. We discussed the plus I effect increases the base strength. As a plus I effect increases, base strength increases, but in non-polar solvent, but in aqueous medium, stability of conjugate acid is important. Similar to plus I effect, the minus I effect, consider, similar to the plus I effect, similar to plus I effect, the plus I effect increase the base strength. On other hand, minus I effect decrease the base strength. Consider this compound, nitrogen atom attached to the 3 trifluoro group. This trifluoro group have minus I effect, and due to the high minus I effect, it withdraw the electron density. Due to the minus I effect, it can't withdraw the electron density of this nitrogen core itself. The electron density present on this nitrogen withdraw by 3 groups by their minus I effect, and this electron density, as electron withdraw by these 3 group, electron density decreases, and as electron density decreases, electron pair not easily available for donation, and this compound generally it is a neutral compound, because this compound have nitrogen, but it does not show the basic character, because in this compound nitrogen atom attached to 3 trifluoro group. The trifluoro group have minus I effect. As the number of trifluoro group increases, minus I effect increases, and due to the high minus I effect, the electron pair of nitrogens are strongly withdrawn by this trifluoro group, their minus I effect, and these lone pair electron not easy available for donation, and due to this reason, this compound generally act as a weaker base, or it is generally neutral compound. This basicity is first factor which is very important. Electron pairs are easy available, then compound generally are basic. But in this compound, the electron pair not easy available for donation, because due to the high minus I effect of this trifluoro group. And due to this reason, sulfate, if electron withdrawing group like nitro, cyano, sulfonyl group, if these are close to the lone pair containing nitrogen atom, then base strength are generally decreases. If any group which have minus I effect when attached to nitrogen, the base strength are generally decreases. Similar to this minus R effect, the minus R effect, electron withdrawing, similar to minus R effect, the minus R effect also decreases the basicity. For example, amides. This is the general formula of amides. It is a primary amides. Amides are generally neutral. What is the reason? In amide, NH2 group is present, nitrogen atom is present, and this nitrogen atom have lone pair electrons. Electron pair is present in the amide nitrogen, but the amides are neutral compound. What is the reason? Why amide does not show basic character, does not show base 10? Why amides are neutral? Because in amides, lone pair containing nitrogen atom attached to this carbonyl group, and this carbonyl group have minus I as well as the minus R effect. Minus R effect we already discussed. Minus R effect containing group attached to nitrogen, lone pair containing nitrogen, then base strength is decreases. This carbonyl also have minus R effect. Why amides are neutral? Because in amides, lone pair containing nitrogen, this NH2 group attached to carbonyl, the carbonyl has minus R and minus R effect, and due to this minus R effect, lone pair electron present on nitrogen atom delocalize into the adjacent carbonyl. This carbonyl withdraw the electron pair on nitrogen toward itself by minus R effect. Lone pair electron undergoes delocalization into the adjacent carbonyl by minus R effect. We can write this structure. Lone pair electron present on nitrogen atom undergoes delocalization into the adjacent carbonyl, and these lone pair electron not easy available for donation. It delocalizes into the adjacent carbonyl by minus R effect. They are not easy available for donation, and due to this reason, amides are neutral compound. Lone pair containing nitrogen NH2 group is present, but they are neutral. Why? NH2 nitro in amide, lone pair containing nitrogen attached to carbonyl, it has minus R, minus R effect. By minus R effect, lone pair electron by minus R effect of carbonyl, lone pair electron undergoes delocalization into this carbonyl. By minus R effect, these lone pair electron delocalize and they are not easy available for donation. If electron pair are available for donation, then compound is base. The basicity is increases, but due to the delocalization or due to the minus R effect, lone pair electron not easy available for donation, and therefore amides are neutral compounds. They generally does not shows basic character. They are neutral compound. Consider the another example. The thalamide is the compound. As the number of carbonyl group increases, this is the thalamide compound. The thalamide contains nitrogen, which have lone pair electron, but thalamides are neutral. It is again amide compound. We already discussed this nitrogen attached to two electron withdrawing carbonyl. It undergoes delocalization into this carbonyl and also this carbonyl, and lone pair electron on nitrogen in thalamide not available for donation, and due to this reason, thalamide is neutral. But thalamide shows acid character. What is the reason? Why it shows acid character? Thalamide is neutral because thalamide is amide compound in which nitrogen attached two electron withdrawing carbonyl. This two electron withdrawing carbonyl has minus R, minus R effect, and due to the minus R effect, lone pair electron undergoes delocalization into both carbonyl, and lone pair electron not available for donation, and due to this reason, thalamide is a neutral compound. But it shows acidic character. Why it is acidic in nature? Thalamide is acidic in nature because after the donation of H+, the conjugate base is formed. If any compound which can donate the H+ ion, according to the Lorentz-Bronsted theory, any substance which can donate the H+ ion generally known as acid. The thalamide donates the H+ ion. This it shows acid character. Why thalamide shows acid character? Because the conjugate base of thalamide is well stabilized by minus R effect. Minus R effect decreases the base strength, but increases the acid strength. Minus R effect decreases the base strength, but minus R and minus R effect increases the acid strength. These two carbon will have minus R effect. Then conjugate base of thalamide is well stabilized by the conjugate base of thalamide is well stabilized by electron vitrifying resonance effect of these two adjacent carbonyl. We can write one more resonating structure. This is the first, second, and we can write three resonating structures. As the number of resonating structures increases, the stability of conjugate base increases. This is the stability of conjugate base increases, and as the stability of conjugate base increases, the acid strength increases. Why? Thalamide is neutral, we discussed. In thalamide, lone pair containing nitrogen attached to carbonyl. The carbonyl have minus R effect, and due to this minus R effect, the lone pair electron present on nitrogen undergoes delocalization into the two adjacent carbonyl group. These lone pair electron not easily available for donation, and due to this reason, thalamide is neutral compound. But it shows acid character because if thalamide donate H plus ion, it on dissociation produces conjugate base. The conjugate base of thalamide is well stabilized by electron withdrawing resonance effect and minus R effect. By electron withdrawing resonance effect, we can draw three resonating structure. Due to the stability of conjugate base, thalamide's conjugate base is more stable due to the minus R and minus R effect of these two carbonyl. Due to the stability of conjugate base of thalamide, these three resonating structures are possible. Number of resonance structure increases, stability increases. The conjugate base of thalamide is stable, and therefore, and due to this reason, thalamide shows acid character. Consider the one more example. The guanidine are stronger base. Why guanidine? It is a guanidine. This is the structure of guanidine. The guanidine are stronger base. What is the reason? Because what is the definition of base? The compound which can donate the electron pair or accept the H plus. If the guanidine accept the H plus ion, the conjugate acid is formed. Consider this conjugate acid of guanidine. The conjugate acid of guanidine guanidine are stronger base. Why? Guanidine is a stronger base because the conjugate acids of guanidine is well stabilized by plus R effect. These are the plus R effect of nitrogen. It can donate the electron. Delocalization of electron pair takes place to the pi bond. This is the resonance effect. Delocalization of electron pair occurs to the pi bond. Generally it is known as resonance. This is the plus R donation of electron occur. It is a plus R effect. Due to the electron donating resonance effect, the conjugate acid of guanidine, the conjugate acid of guanidine is well stabilized by electron donating resonance effect of these two NH2 group. This is the first resonating structure. We can write again the same third resonating structure. We can write the three resonating structures. And due to the plus R effect in guanidine, conjugate acid of guanidine is more stable. And due to this reason, guanidine shows it is a generally stronger base. Why guanidine is a stronger base? Because conjugate acid of guanidine is well stabilized by electron donating resonance effect of 2NH2 group. The three resonating structures are possible. The conjugate acid of guanidine is more stable, and due to the more stability of conjugate acid of guanidine, the guanidine are stronger base. These are the aliphatic amides and their relative strength. In aliphatic amide, the relative base strength is depends on availability of electron pair, and availability of electron pair depends on inductive effect and resonance effect. Plus R effect increases the base strength. minus R effect generally decreases the base stress. In primary, secondary, tertiary amine, aliphatic amine, in aqueous medium, base strength is different. Tertiary amine is weaker than secondary amine because in aqueous medium, base strength is depends on stability of conjugate acid. It is depends on solvation. Conjugate acid of secondary amine is more solvated than conjugate acid of tertiary amine in aqueous medium, and due to this reason, the secondary amine is a stronger base than tertiary amine. But we measure the base strength, primary, secondary, and tertiary amine in nonpolar solvent. In nonpolar solvent, stability of conjugate acid is not useful to decide the base strength. In this case, electronic effect, inductive effect is important. As the number of alkyl group increase from primary to secondary, secondary to tertiary amine, as the number of alkyl group increases, inductive effect increases, and as inductive effect increases, electron density around the nitrogen atom increases and the base strength increases. In next lecture, we discuss the relative base strength for aromatic amine. Now we can stop here.